Yeah, it's very, very, very meaningful to me, particularly that the British public have come out and seen this movie in droves at the cinema. To an incredible degree. That also, more largely, makes me feel as though people are coming back to the movies, and that's great for all of us who try and earn a living out of it, for sure.
We met at the premiere of Belfast at the London Film Festival. How would you describe the whole, you know, arch of the film and what's happened with all this award buzz?
It seems rather insane to me. I've never been involved in something like this. It's, sometimes you think, this is really excessive. You know, this is a small story that we made to touch people, or hopefully they would connect with it. And it has, and that's why it has this success, because it really has connected with people.
What was the sentiment on set, you know, because as you said, this is a very truthful story said in a truthful tone. Was it a special one?
Yeah, it was very quiet. Because, I mean, we were one of the first films to be made on the back of the first outbreak of COVID. And nothing much was happening. So there's one idea that, A, we were actors who were grateful for a job, right? But for all of us, because Ken had sought us out, I guess for whatever we carry inside ourselves, as we are representative of his own people.
So tell us, you know, how it feels. You know, I'm sure it's not your first BAFTAs, but tonight is special.
Oh, tonight is very special. I think it's special for lots of reasons. Firstly, we're all coming together for the first time in many years. And it feels like we have an opportunity again to look at cinema and to see its place in the world.
Troy, how are you? Do you remember me? We met on Zoom a couple of weeks ago. Same year. And I predicted, the SAG Award win. So how did it feel that night? It must have been such a special night.
Oh my Lord, it was such a special night because there's so many actors in SAG. It's not directors and writers, but these are all actors. And I'm an actor myself. So I understand many of the struggles they went through, and we've had parallel experiences.
Do you feel that CODA was received the way you felt you wanted the audience to?
Absolutely. I really believe we impacted our audience in the correct way, because it was really hard for many people to understand the deaf cultural experience and what sign language is. And so really, it was the right time and the right place. And during the pandemic, you know, a lot of people have passed away and some have really struggled to survive. And seeing our film, it really reminds folks to really appreciate their families.
Thank you so much. It's such a privilege to meet you in person. And I'm rooting for you.
I'm extraordinarily proud. It's a remarkable achievement, and all centering around the genius that is Jane Campion. And to be asked to do anything for her and with her, let alone to play someone as complex and challenging as Phil Burbank, was just a dream come true.